Okay, my name is Steven Erickson, although that is a pen name, and I write fantasy and science fiction, but primarily right now, I guess I'm promoting the fantasy series, The Melasm Book of the Fallen, and if I were to think of influences for the series, I would think Stephen R. Donaldson's Thomas Covenant trilogies and Glenn Cook's Black Company. The Melasm world is a secondary world, not related to this one. And the stories are part of a history of an empire. And they explore as many points of view within that empire and outside that empire to describe a thesis, if you will, of cultures in conflict, civilizations in conflict, cultures in transition. And it's also a world where there is magic and a world where the gods exist. And so because of those two factors, it is a very different world from this one. Imagine a high priest praying or saying to his followers, "All you women must wear clothing to cover your faces and your heads and everything else, because that is what God has said." And then a god speaking, "Wait a minute, no, I didn't say anything of the sort." And so in other words, the notion of moral authority changes if the gods are actually present in the world. And so that was one of the things we wanted to explore in the series. The other thing is with magic, we thought about magic being egalitarian and available to anyone. And through that, we realized that, and when I say we, I mean myself and Ian C.S. Lamont, we were co-creators of the world. We realized that you would have a world without sexism because you could have no gender-based hierarchy of power. No one could be exclusive or inclusive in terms of power. And that changes the entire culture and all of the civilizations in the world. So it was a kind of a thought experiment, but also lots of adventure. It came through role-playing games. Myself and Ian S. Lamont, we were both archaeologists, so we spent summers working on digs in various places. Then we both began to explore writing fiction. So we were flatmates in Victoria and various other places, and we role-played. Dungeons and Dragons and GURPS, Steve Jackson's generic universal role-playing system. And through those games, we basically established the backdrop, the foundation of the Melasm world. And we played it through in the games and created many characters who show up in the novels later. And so that took, 4 or 5 years at least. We did a feature film script that was actually the last quarter of Gardens of the Moon, the first novel. Could not find a buyer for it, and eventually decided that each of us would write novels recounting the history of the Melasm Empire. And that was primarily our motivation. And it took, I'd say, 10 years before the novels started showing up, and then it took me 8 years to get a publisher for Gardens of the Moon. And so it's been a long time in gestation. Most people are not being deliberately evil, regardless of what they do. They will probably have strong motivations and reasons for doing the things they do. We were never interested in a universe that tried to assert pure good and pure evil. If you're going to explore the human condition, you have to acknowledge that there is good and bad in all of us. And so we wanted that sense for all of the characters, is that everyone is flawed. Everyone is capable of both heinous acts and acts of profound bravery, sometimes at the same time. So it makes for more complicated characterization by far, yes. And I mean, that's what sort of humanizes the story. Even though you've got dragons and the undead and magic and gods, ultimately the human condition is the core of every story. I remember watching the cover being done. The engagement of these publishers, Jean-Philippe Leha, has been far and above the engagement I have received from any other foreign language publisher. So I'm very pleased. I'm very, very happy to know that they've got 5 books published or translated already, and the intention is to release one every 6 months, and that will maintain some momentum for the readers. They don't have to wait too long. It's a completed series anyway, so 5 years from now, all 10 books will be done, and that's terrific. That's very good news. I think we have 2 people to thank for it. One is Peter Jackson for Lord of the Rings, and the other is George R.R. Martin for kicking open the door in television for epic fantasy. And now, of course, we've got the Black Company. It has been purchased, so we're going to see the Black Company. Some of Terry Brooks' works are now apparent in television, and I think that's it's as if fantasy was the last frontier for television to conquer, and probably a lot of it had to do with CGI and special effects and the fact of the costs of production are going down, but also a kind of legitimization of fantasy beyond geeks and people like that. So it's become much more popular across the board. And George is certainly responsible for a lot of that. And so I'm delighted that he was able to get everything up and running and to get it going so that other production companies could look at fantasy and see that this is a huge market. And the time has come to actually produce things on television. So fingers crossed, the Melazin world will someday be on television.